Hey, how's it going, guys? Welcome back to another video. It's good to be back and posting again on a semi-regular basis anyway. And today we're actually gonna be doing a tutorial, which I know is a little strange considering in the last video I posted last week, I said that probably won't be doing as many tutorials, but I just happened to stumble upon something kind of fun in DaVinci Resolve whilst editing that video, and it has been a few months since I'd edited the video, so I thought I'd show you that in today's video. I just said video too many times, it's lost all meaning. For all of you out there that don't want to sort of watch this intro, I guess I'll just drop a timestamp right here. You can jump to that if you want to watch the tutorial. I don't want any of y'all jumping in the comments going, tutorial starts at a minute 20. No one likes that person, so I've done it for you. So yeah, anyway, so last week I did a video sort of talking about why I wasn't on YouTube, and I also sort of did a quick little setup video of like filming, I don't know, just setting up this like cheap little backdrop thing. And I'll show you what I mean. So in terms of how I was filming, excuse the bedroom, so I had, and the cat, so I had my camera set up here, and then I had my like phone on a tripod, pointing this way, shooting with like an ultra wide lens. And I just thought, hey, like whatever, I'll just do it that way and I'll figure out how to crop it into a vertical video and so I can upload it on Instagram stories and all that sort of stuff later. One sec, guys. Cat is a little bit of a troublemaker. Yeah, anyway, so I had that filmed and I shot it ultra wide, and then I took that footage into DaVinci Resolve and used the auto reframe feature. Try saying that five times fast. Auto reframe, auto reframe, auto reframe. All right, it's not that hard. I used the auto reframe feature in DaVinci Resolve, and I do think it is a DaVinci Resolve studio feature. So yeah, the auto reframe feature, basically if you zoom in on your footage, you wanna like crop in a little bit, you hit the auto reframe, it's gonna find the subject of the footage and basically do like a fake camera move for you. So I'm gonna show you how to do it because it's super simple, and I actually think the way I did it for this is actually a really good use case for that feature in DaVinci Resolve. Like I said, I shot myself ultra wide on the iPhone, and then when I wanted to upload it for like a YouTube short and an Instagram story or reel or whatever all these things are, all the vertical videos are these days, I basically imported that ultra wide footage into, we'll show you in the tutorial. Let's just jump into DaVinci Resolve.
So in here in DaVinci Resolve, you can see this bit of footage here. So this is the ultra wide footage from the iPhone. See me cleaning around, my cat, lovely cat. So what we're gonna do is bring this into a vertical timeline. So we're just gonna right click, go new timeline, and instead of project settings, change the format, and we're gonna go custom, and then just reverse this. So 1080 by 1920 and just create. So now we have our vertical format, and we're just gonna bring that whole clip in here. And so you can see it doesn't quite fit. So what we really wanna do is we're going to select that clip, and then in our inspector over here under the video tab, we're just gonna zoom in, right? So that it fills the frame, and that looks about right. Now, if you want a border, you can obviously bring it in a little bit, but I'm just gonna fill the frame. And all we really need to do now is go to Smart Reframe just underneath it, and it's got Object of Interest, it's set to auto. You can actually pick, if you go reference point, it'll actually let you put a box around what you want. So it can either be me or I could do the cat or whatever, but auto is going to select a person. And then we're gonna reframe it, and it will take not too long, maybe 10 seconds or so. And then when it finishes, we'll have a moving clip basically with a fake camera move. So now if I play this footage back, you can see that it just follows me around, and all of a sudden we've turned what was a static shot into, well, what looks like a camera that is just tracking me throughout the frame. So it's a really easy thing to do. Now, what I'm gonna show you though, this smart reframe only works if you resize the footage. So bring a different bit of footage in. If I was just to do a reframe on this, nothing's going to happen because everything is already in the frame. And as you can see here, nothing has happened. And that's because everything is already in the frame, so it's not going to reframe. The moment I zoom in is when stuff's gonna happen. Now, I could also change the object of interest for this one just so that we have an example. And I'm just going to make this the object of interest. Let's zoom in a bit more. All right, and then I'm just going to go reframe. So there you go. So nothing is going to move in this shot now because obviously this is a static object, but you can see here that it has reframed the shot. Now it does lose it when I move, and then once I move out of the shot, so you can see the moment I cover it up, which is about here, stays in frame. The moment I cover up, it then snaps to the next logical point of interest, which is myself. So you can see how this is like pretty much just a cameraman in your pocket.
So yeah, that's pretty much it, guys. Like, it's not like a super advanced tutorial, but I was intrigued by the use case that I came across and thought that maybe, hey, a lot of us have phones, a lot of us have like the new ones with the ultra wide cameras, and this is actually a pretty useful feature, and I'm probably gonna be using it a bunch because it means I don't have to do much editing, right? You just shoot ultra wide, crop in, done. So yeah, no, I thought it was kind of cool. That's why I shared it with you guys. If you thought the same, make sure you hit that thumbs up button. You know, support the channel, subscribe to the channel if you're not already. See you in the next video, I guess, whenever that one pops. See ya.